In the previous video, we were introduced to a new way of approaching equilibrium problems. We called these our ICE tables. So I stood for initial, C stood for change, and E stood for equilibrium. And the idea is that if you have a balanced chemical reaction, right, and specifically a balanced equilibrium. So the example that we saw in the previous video was the decomposition of ammonia to make nitrogen gas and hydrogen gas. Well, then you can set up an ICE table with three columns, I, C, and E, where the I stands for the initial conditions, E stands for the equilibrium conditions, and C stands for the change that happens between the initial and the equilibrium conditions. So the C row is really important, and we usually represent it in the context of an X. So whichever side of the reaction you're losing, it would be minus, and you always weight it by this stoichiometric coefficient. So it'd be minus 2x for ammonia. If we lose reactants, we gain products. So it would be plus x for nitrogen and plus 3x for hydrogen, because there are 3 moles of hydrogen that are produced for every 1 mole of nitrogen that's produced. Okay, and then the idea is that you just add up the initial and the change and you get to the equilibrium, right? So that's why these ICE tables are really important or really useful, because they allow you to express the equilibrium conditions in terms of a single variable. Okay, and in the previous video, we saw that that was really useful when we were trying to calculate K if we were explicitly told one of the equilibrium concentrations. So we were actually told the concentration of hydrogen at equilibrium. I'm going to abbreviate EQ here. And since we knew that, we could solve for X. And once we know X, we can calculate the equilibrium concentrations of everything else. Okay, so in this video, let's go ahead and use this ICE table to solve a similar problem. Okay, so in this problem, we are told that 9 atmospheres of ammonia gas is allowed to decompose. When equilibrium has been reached, so at equilibrium, the total pressure is equal to 16.86 atmospheres. Okay, we want to figure out what is the equilibrium constant. And I'm going to specify Kp here. Okay, Kp because we are using atmospheres in our equilibrium calculation. Okay, so let's think about what we know. We know that initially 9 atmospheres of ammonia is added. So we have 9 atmospheres here. Okay, we're told nothing about nitrogen or hydrogen, so we can assume initially there's none of those gases. Okay, our change is going to be minus 2x for ammonia plus x for nitrogen plus 3x for hydrogen, and then our equilibrium condition is we add together the I and the C. So we have 9 minus 2x, x, and 3x. Okay, so this right here is the equilibrium pressure of ammonia, x is the equilibrium pressure of nitrogen, and 3x is the equilibrium pressure of hydrogen. Okay. Other pieces of information we're given here is that the total pressure is 16.86 atmospheres. And we know that the total pressure is always calculated by adding up the pressures of all the gases. So it's going to be the equilibrium pressure of ammonia plus the equilibrium pressure of nitrogen plus the equilibrium pressure of hydrogen, right? We know that the total pressure is always the sum of the individual gases and their pressures. And since we have expressions for each of these, pressure of ammonia, pressure of nitrogen, and pressure of hydrogen at equilibrium, we can make some substitutions here. We know that the total pressure is 16.86 atmospheres. That's part of the problem. We know the pressure of ammonia is 9 minus 2x. We know the pressure of nitrogen is x, and we know the pressure of hydrogen is 3x. So what we can see here is that we're left with a single variable, x, and we're able to solve for x. So if we simplify this side, so we have 16.86 equals 9 plus 2x. We have negative 2x plus x plus 3x, so negative 2x plus 4x is equal to 2x. And if we go through here and solve for x, we're going to see that x equals 3.93 atmospheres. I did that by subtracting 9 from both sides and dividing by 2. Okay, so we know x now. So we're able to figure out the equilibrium pressure of ammonia because we know the equilibrium pressure of ammonia is equal to 9 minus 2 times x. So the equilibrium pressure of ammonia is equal to 1.136 atmospheres. We can figure out the equilibrium pressure of nitrogen. It's equal to x, so it's 3.93 atmospheres. All right, that's right here. And we can figure out the equilibrium pressure of hydrogen, which is 3 times x. This is 11.796 atmospheres. So once we've solved for x, we're able to use our ice table to figure out how to calculate the equilibrium pressure of each of our gases, ammonia, nitrogen, and hydrogen. And then the final step is to take these values and plug them into an equilibrium constant expression. So K equals the pressure of nitrogen times the pressure of hydrogen cubed divided by the pressure of ammonia squared. And we know all these values now. We figured them out. So we're able to plug these values in and solve for the equilibrium constant. And when you do that, we're going to get K equals, so it's 3.93 times 11.796 cubed divided by 1.136 squared. And this is going to end up being equal to 5,000. So KP here is 5,000. Okay, so the two ways we've seen to use ice tables right now are when you're told initial concentrations or initial amounts, and you are given some information about equilibrium. And from that information, you can solve for x, which allows you to calculate the equilibrium constant. Okay, so if you know information about initial concentrations and at least something about equilibrium, you'll be able to solve for x. And once you know x, you can solve for the equilibrium constant. In the next video, we're going to see the last example of how to use ice tables, and that's when you don't know information about equilibrium, but you do know the equilibrium constant.